In this video, I'm going to show you how to batch resize images in Photoshop two quick and easy ways. So the first thing we need to do is create two folders. Now I've already created two folders and they're on my desktop. And the first folder is my source folder. And this has several images that I want to resize. Then I created another folder. I call it Square Output. And this is my destination folder. So my images in the square folder are going to get resized and they're going to get copied over to the square output folder. Next thing we need to do is create a Photoshop action. This image on the screen right now is going to be our test image while we're creating the action. So here in this example, I have a group of images that I want to post to my Squarespace website. And the maximum width is 2,500 pixels and it needs to be a JPEG. So I checked those requirements on the Squarespace site and that's what they require. So I'm going to come up here to my actions and I'm going to create a new set. I'm going to call that set resize images. Next, I'm going to start creating my action. So I'm going to click on the new action icon and I'm going to name it resize for Squarespace. The set is already pointing to the resize images set that I created. And now I'm going to say record. And I'm going to come up here to image size. Now, as far as the dimensions and the width and the height, we're going to be working with pixels. The resample option should be checked and it should be automatic. And so the next option that is important is this chain right here. So this chain should not be broken. Right now it is not broken. You can tell by these lines. And what that does, it allows me to put in the 2,500 pixel width that I have. And it automatically changed the height for me. So it maintains the aspect ratio of this image. So make sure that chain's not broken. And you can choose the width or the height as your guiding measurement. But in this case, I know that the width is supposed to be 2,500 pixels maximum. And I'll say okay. So now I need to record a save as dialog. So if I come up here to file, save as, and now I'm gonna save this to my computer. So when you have the save as dialog box up, some important things to think about. Make sure on the format that you've selected the file type that you want. Sometimes it defaults to something else like TIFF or PSD. But in this case, I know that Squarespace wants a JPEG file. And so the good thing to remember, if you use the save as function like we're doing here as part of your action, we need to point the save as location to the destination folder that you had made earlier. That way, when you run this action, it will always send your processed images to whichever destination folder you choose. So I'm gonna choose my square output and say save. Take note of this last window that pops up that says JPEG options. So I'll say okay. And now I could stop my recording and here's my action. I'm gonna test my action now. I'm gonna go back to the start of my history. Going to actions. Here's where my output folder is. I'm going to test my action, press play, and there it's been resized. And there's the file in my output folder now. So we know the action works. So now we're going to see how we can use our action to apply it to a folder so that we can batch resize all the images in it. So we're going to come up here to File, Automate, Batch. So up here in the Play submenu, we're going to make sure we select the set. The set was resized images. An action was resize for Squarespace. Now we need to choose a folder and let's choose where we have our destination folder. It's on the desktop. It was called Square. We selected it. You see all the images here. We'll say choose. And we don't need to check any of these other options right now. We don't have any open commands or we don't need to suppress any file open options dialog. Now we need to come up to the destination submenu. Folder should be selected, and when we say choose, we're going to choose our output destination, which in this case it's called Square Output. So this is the same folder that we created in the first step, and it's also the same destination that we chose when we were creating the action in the save as step. Say choose. All these other options are okay right now. We don't need to choose anything else. And when I click OK, it's going to resize all the images in my source folder and put them in my destination folder. Say okay. Gonna take a while. Here is my square output folder and dimensions are 2500 by 1667. These are the dimensions that we resize these images to. So I can go ahead and upload these to Squarespace or you can do this for any other blog or Facebook. So this is the first batch resize method. This method requires you to have Photoshop open and run the file automate batch utility from within Photoshop. Let's see how you can do this without Photoshop even being open. If you get any value out of this so far, hit that like button. So now we're gonna turn our Photoshop action into a Photoshop droplet. So we'll come up here to File, Automate, Create Droplet. It's very similar to the Automate Batch panel. So up here is where you're gonna save your droplet. I'm gonna say choose, and I'm gonna put this on the desktop. It's called Resize for Squarespace. So I'm on a Mac. The file extension would be different on Windows. It would probably be EXE. So I'm gonna say save. And so on the Play submenu, you're selecting your action. It's resize images. The action that we're using, it's called resize for Squarespace. I don't need to choose any of these options here. In a destination folder, I will choose that. That is my square output folder on my desktop. Say choose, and I'm gonna say okay. I'm going to close Photoshop, and here's my droplet. This is what it looks like here on my desktop. Here's my square folder with all of my images. So now all I have to do is click and drag this over onto this icon. But what I want to do is, here's my output folder. I'm going to drag my entire source folder onto my droplet icon. So it's opening up Photoshop. It'll take a minute. So you can see it opened up Photoshop in the background. It's opening up each image and running the action. And you see my output folder as each image has been resized by Photoshop. So I didn't need Photoshop open to begin with. As soon as I dragged the source folder onto the droplet, it started to work. So droplets are really helpful when you have a lot of images that you have to do the same thing to. It's easier than using an action within Photoshop and running it against each image. If you want to know more about Photoshop, click or tap on one of the videos on the screen now. If you haven't already, subscribe, like, and share this video. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.